19 जनवरी 2021 मॉर्निंग मुरली ओम शांति बाप दादा मधुबन स्वीट चिल्ड्रन रिमेंबर योर स्वीट फादर एंड यू विल बिकेम सतप्रधान डीटीज एवरीथिंग डिपेंड्स ऑन द पिलग्रिमेज ऑफ रिमेंबरेंस क्वेश्चन जस्ट एज यू चिल्ड्रन एक्सपीरियंस द फादर्स पुल इन द सेम वे फ्रॉम विच चिल्ड्रन Will everyone experience a pull? Answer: From those who have become flowers, just as little children are flowers and are unaware of vices, and so everyone is attracted to them. In the same way, when you children became flowers, that is, when you became pure, everyone will be attracted. There should be no thorns of vice in you. Om Shanti, you spiritual children know that this is the most auspicious confluence age. Can you see your most elevated faces of the future? Can you see your most elevated costumes? Can you feel that you will once again go to the golden age new world of Lakshmi and Narayan's dynasty, that is, to the land of happiness, and that you will become the most elevated beings. While sitting here, do you have these thoughts? When students are studying, their intellects are aware in which class they are studying. I will become a barrister, or I will become so and so. In the same way, when you sit here, you are aware that you will go into Vishnu dynasty. The two forms of Vishnu are Lakshmi and Narayan, a god and goddesses. Your intellects are now alaukik. These things would not be turning around in the intellect of anyone else. All of these things are in the intellects of you children. This is not a common satsang, means the company of truth. You are sitting here with the understanding that you are sitting in the company of the true Baba, who is called Shiva. Shiva Baba alone is the creator. He alone knows the beginning, middle, and end of creation, and he gives us that knowledge. It is as though he is telling us a matter of yesterday. While sitting here, you must remember that you have come here to be rejuvenated. That is to change your bodies into deity bodies. The soul says, this is my Tamapradhan old body, which I have to change and became like Lakshmi and Narayan. Your aim and objective is so elevated. The teacher who is teaching you would definitely be clever than the students who are studying. He is educating us and teaching us to perform good actions. And so he must surely be elevated. You know that God, the highest on high, is teaching us. In the future, we will become deities like them. The things we are studying are for the future new world. No one else even knows about the new world. It now enters your intellect that Lakshmi and Narayan were the masters of the new world. It must definitely repeat. The father explains, I teach you and change you from human beings into deities. It will definitely be number wise among the deities too. It is a divine kingdom, is it not? Throughout the day, you must have the thought, I am a soul. I, the soul that was very impure, am now remembering the pure father in order to become pure. You also have to understand the meaning of remembrance. The soul remembers his sweet father. The father himself says, children, by remembering me, you will become Satapradhan deities. everything depends on the pilgrimage of remembrance. The father would definitely ask children, "For how long do you remember me?" It is in remembrance that there is a battle with Maya. You yourself can also understand when it is not a pilgrimage but more like a battle. There are many obstacles in this. Maya creates obstacles for you on the pilgrimage of remembrance. That is, she makes you forget. You say, "Baba, we have many storms of Maya while staying in remembrance of you." The number one storm is body consciousness. Then it is lust, then anger, greed, attachment and ego. Children say, "Baba, we try a lot not to have obstacles when we stay in remembrance. But in spite of that, there are storms. Today it is a storm of anger, or today there is a storm of greed. Today my stage was very good and I didn't have any storms. I stay on the pilgrimage of remembrance the whole day and I had a lot of happiness. I remembered Baba a great deal." Tears of love continue to flow in remembrance. By staying in remembrance of the father, you will become sweet. You children understand where you have reached by being defeated by Maya. Some children accumulate how many months and days there are in the cycle. It enters your intellect that if someone says that the duration of the cycle is hundreds of thousands of years, no one could then calculate anything. The father explains that this world cycle continues to turn. You know how many births you take in the whole cycle and how you go into the dynasty. These are completely new things. It is new knowledge for the new world. Heaven is called the new world. You would say that you are human beings at present and that you are becoming deities. The deity status is elevated. You children know that you are receiving unique knowledge. The one who is teaching us is unique, without an image. He doesn't have a corporeal image. He is always incorporeal. Just see how he had such a good part in the drama. How does the father teach us? He himself tells you, "I enter such and such a body." He also tells you which body he enters. People became confused. Does he always come in the same body? However, this is the drama. There cannot be any change in it. Only you listen to these things and imbibe them and then relate them to others in the same way that Shiv Baba teaches you. We then teach other souls. It is souls that study. It is souls that study and teach others. Souls are most valuable. Souls are imperishable and immortal. It is just the bodies that are destroyed. We souls are receiving knowledge from our Supreme Father, the Supreme Soul. We are receiving the knowledge of the Creator and the beginning, middle and end of creation and of the 84 births. Who is receiving this knowledge? Souls are receiving it. Souls are imperishable. Attachment should only be to imperishable things, not perishable things. You have had attachment to the perishable bodies for so long. You now understand that each of you is a soul and that you have to renounce the consciousness of your body. Some children write, "I, the soul, did this work. I, the soul, gave this lecture today. I, the soul, remembered Baba a lot today." That one is the Supreme Soul, knowledgeful. He is giving you children so much knowledge. You know the incorporeal world and the subtle region. People have no awareness of anything in their intellects. Your intellects are aware of who the creator is. The creator of this human world is remembered, and so he must definitely come here to act. You know that no other human beings remember the soul or the supreme soul. The Father alone gives you this knowledge. Consider yourselves to be souls. By considering yourselves to be bodies, you have been dangling upside down. The soul is truth, a living being and an embodiment of bliss. The maximum praise is of the soul. There is so much praise of the soul of the one Father. He alone is the remover of sorrow and the bestower of happiness. Mosquitoes would not be praised as being removers of sorrow and bestowers of happiness or oceans of knowledge. No, this is the Father's praise. Each one of you is also a remover of sorrow and a bestower of happiness, because you are the children of that Father who removes everyone's sorrow and gives them happiness. Are you not? And that is for half the cycle too. No one else has this knowledge. Only the one Father is knowledgeful. We had no knowledge. If we didn't even know the one Father, what other knowledge would we have had? You now feel that you are the ones who take this knowledge first. Previously, you didn't know anything. A baby doesn't have any knowledge or any defects. Therefore, because it is pure, a baby is said to be a great soul. The younger the child, the more it would be a number one flower. It would be almost as though he is in his karmatit stage. He doesn't know anything about actions or sinful actions. The baby just knows itself. He is a flower and therefore attracts everyone, just as Baba is now attracting you. The Father has come to make all of you into flowers. You also have some very bad thorns in you. There are the thorns of the five vices. At this time, you have the knowledge of flowers and thorns. There is also a forest of thorns. The thorns of a bubble bush are very big. Many things are made from those thorns. Thorns are compared to human beings. The Father explains, at this time, there are many human thorns who causes a lot of sorrow. This is why this world is called the world of sorrow. Then even say, the Father is the bestower of happiness. Maya, Ravan, is the bestower of sorrow. Then, in the golden age, Maya will not exist, and so thus things will not exist there either. In a drama, the same part is not played twice. It is in your intellect that every part being played is new. Just think about it. From the golden age until now, the days change and the whole activity changes. The record of the complete activity of 5000 years is recorded in you souls, and this cannot change. Each soul has his own part recorded. No one can understand this one single thing. You now know the beginning, middle and end. This is a school, is it not? You have to know the beginning, middle and end of the world. This is also a study to remember the Father and to become pure. Prior to this, did you know that you had to become like that? The Father explains everything so clearly. You were in that first number and you then gradually came down. And you have now become this. Look what the world has become. There are so many human beings. Just think about what the kingdom of Lakshmi and Narayan will be like. The palaces where they live will be studded with jewels and diamonds. It enters your intellect that you are now becoming residents of heaven. There you will build your own palaces. It isn't that Dwarika means golden city of Krishna will emerge from down below as they are portrayed in the scriptures. The word scriptures has continued. They cannot call them anything else. Other books are used for studying. Another type of book is a novel. However, these are called scriptures or religious books. Other books are for studying from. Those who study the scriptures are called devotees. There are the two things, devotion and knowledge. What is their disinterest in devotion or knowledge? It would surely be said to be devotion. You are now receiving knowledge through which you became so elevated. The Father is now making you into bestowers of happiness. The land of happiness is called heaven. You are going to go to the land of happiness, and so he teaches you. It is you souls who take this knowledge. Souls don't have a religion. A soul is a soul. It is when a soul enters a body that the religion of the body is different. What is the religion of souls? A soul is like a point and is an embodiment of peace. Souls reside in the land of peace, the land of liberation. The Father now explains, all children have a right. There are many children who have been converted to other religions. They will then emerge and come back to their original religion. Those who have left the deity religion and gone into other religions will all return to their place. No one else would be able to understand these things. First of all, give the Father's introduction. It is in this that everyone becomes confused. You children now know who is teaching you. The Father is teaching you. Krishna is a bodily being. This one means Brahma is called Dada. All are brothers. Then it all depends on the status. This is the body of a brother and this is the body of a sister. You now know this too. A soul is just a tiny star. All of this knowledge is in just a tiny star. A star cannot speak without a body. A star needs organs with which to play a part. The world of stars is separate. Then a soul comes here and adopts a body. That is the home of souls. A soul is a tiny point, whereas a body is a big thing. Therefore, people remember that the body so much. You now have to remember the one Supreme Father, the Supreme Soul. He is the truth. When the gathering of souls and the Supreme Soul take place, it is also remembered. Souls remain separated from the Supreme Soul for a long time. We became separated from Baba. Do you remember for how long you have been separated? The Father comes and tells you what he has been telling you every cycle. There cannot be the slightest change in that. Every act that takes place second by second is new. It is as though you leave behind every second that passes, every minute that passes. They continue to pass so that you can then say, you have passed through so many years, days, minutes and seconds. There will be the full 5000 years and it will then start from number 1. There is the accurate account. Every minute and second are noted. If someone were to ask you how many births someone has taken, you could calculate and give the answer. Krishna took the number 1 birth. You could not calculate every minute and second for Shiva. The date, time and moment for Krishna has been mentioned. There can be the difference of a minute or a second in the clocks of human beings, but there cannot be the slightest change in the moment that Shiva Baba incarnates. You can't even tell when he came. It isn't that he came when Baba had visions. No, one can only estimate. It isn't that he entered at the time when Baba had a vision that he was to become so and so. Achha, to the sweetest, beloved, long lost and now found children, love, remembrance and good morning from the mother, the father, Bab Dada, the spiritual father says Namaste to the spiritual children. The spiritual children says Namaste and good morning to the spiritual father. Essence for the dharana. First point, in order to go to the land of happiness, become a bestower of happiness, remove everyone's sorrow and give them happiness. Never become a thorn that causes sorrow. Second point, the soul in this perishable body is most valuable. It is immortal and imperishable. Therefore, have love for imperishable things. Finish the consciousness of the body. Blessing. May you be courageous and on the basis of one's strength and one's support, experience your destination to be close. Explanation. Before you reach your highest destination, there will definitely be hurricanes and storms. In order to go across to the other side, a steamer has to go through the middle of an ocean. Therefore, do not quickly become afraid, become tired or stop. Keep your companion with you and all difficulties will become easy. Be courageous and worthy of receiving the Father's help. Always keep the lesson of one's strength and one's support firm and you will easily be able to pass through the birthful, means the middle of the ocean, and experience your destination to be close. Slogan, a world benefactor is one who has good wishes for every soul as well as for matter. Om Shanti.